ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैवं नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अवत्रेषु नित्यं भागवतसेवयां भगवतीं उत्तमश्लोकीं भक्तिं भवदीर्नैष्ठिहि। श्रीमद् भागवतम कांडो 10 चैप्टर 4 द अट्रोसिटीज ऑफ किंग कंसा टेक्स्ट 30 कांडो 10 चैप्टर 4 टेक्स्ट 30 आकर्ण्य भर्तुर् कडितम् आकर्ण्य पर्तोर कडितम् तमुचु देवसत्रवत् तमुचु देवसत्रवत् देवान् प्रतिकृतमर्षा देवान् प्रतिकृतमर्षा तैतेयानादिकोविदा। आकर्ण्या आफ्टर हियरिंग पर्तो ऑफ देयर मास्टर कडितम द वर्ड्स ऑफ स्टेटमेंट तम उच्चु रिप्लाई टू हिम देवसत्रव ऑल द असुरास हू वर एनिमीज ऑफ द डेमी गॉड्स देवान द डेमी गॉड्स प्रदि टुवर्ड कृत अमर्षा हू वर एनवियस दैत्यया द असुरास नॉट अधिकोविदा who were very expert in executing transactions. Translation purport by Srila Prabhupada. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. After hearing their master statement, the envious asuras, who are enemies of the demigods and were not very expert in their dealings, advised Kamsa as follows. Purport. There are two types of men, the asuras and suras. तो बोध सर्कव लोके अस्मिन् दैव आसुर एव च विष्णु भक्त स्मृत दैव आसुर तत् विपर्यया पद्मपुराण। दोस हु आर डिवोटीज ऑफ लॉर्ड विष्णु कृष्ण आर सुरास आर देवास वेर दोस हु आर अपोज टू द डिवोटीज आर कॉल्ड असुरास। Devotees are expert in all transactions. Yashyadi bhaktir bhagavadi ahinchana sarvair gunai tatra samasadi sura. Therefore they are called kovida, which means expert. Asuras, however, although superficially showing expertise in passionate activities, are actually are fools. They are neither sober nor expert. Whatever they do is imperfect. Mokasa moga karmana. According to this description of asuras, given in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 9, text 12, whatever they do will ultimately be baffled. It was such a person who advised Kamsa because they were his chief friends and ministers. नमो विष्णु पदाय कृष्णाय बोले श्रीमदे भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नामिनि नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणी निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशधारिणी श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण आई बेग परमिशन फ्रॉम ऑल सीनियर डिवोटीज एंड वैष्णवास टू ब्लेस मी give this lecture. With their blessings, I will try to tell something. This sloka is very much connected to Asura. Kamsa was told by the Yoga Maya, the child has born somewhere else. Then Kamsa was convinced by Devaki and Vasudeva, they will obey his rule and all those things. Finally, Kamsa was taking the counseling of his ministers. Prabhupada is telling this, it was such a person who advised Kamsa because they were his chief friends and ministers. Because Kamsa was advised by Asuras, Mohakasa Moha Karmana, they are baffled their material activity. Those people advised to Kamsa, therefore he also got lost. And in this whole process, this Sura Asura, Sura is Devas, from Padma Purana Prabhupada is quoting. And Asura means opposite, Asura, non-devotees. Sura is Vishnu Bhakta. Vishnu Bhakta Smrito Daiva. Devotees are called Sura and non-devotees are called Asura. Those who are devotees are Lord Vishnu Krishna, they are Suras or Devas. Whereas those who are opposed to the devotees are called Asuras. This is the basic definition of Sura and Asura. But the main difficulty with this guna is coming, asura and sura, their nature, is explained in the 17th chapter, 16th chapter of Bhagavad Gita very nicely, the difference between these two characters. The main character, the asura is having, they don't know pravrittimsa, nivrittimsa, what to be done, what not to be done. And it is very important in a society, we need to know what is to be done, what not to be done. Even in the common people, the common government, material government, they have a lot of laws. Similarly, human society also has a lot of laws created by the Lord, by Shastra. And if they don't know what to follow, what not to follow, chaos means total confusion. It may be any level. The level may be small or big, a house or become a small district or big country or world or prapancha, everywhere rules are there. In Kumar Sasti, Prabhupada often tells our governments are making rules only for human people, human beings, not for other entities. But the Lord's rules are for all living entities. We need to respect all rules for all living entities. Nowadays, we are not even following the rules for human beings. What to talk about the rules for other living entities? Therefore, we are becoming asuras. We are not following. Actually, suras follows. Asuras, they don't follow. Sura, devas, they have also sense gratifying mode. The asuras also having sense gratifying mode. There is no difference. Visa, Indra, Chandra, Agni, and all. So many mistakes they do, sense gratification activities. What is wrong? They are also having, the asuras also having. How does it differ? We certainly see both are having sense gratification mode, but how does it differ? Certainly one is trying to achieve by praying the Lord. Akama, sarvakama, mokshakama, udharadi. Another is without a sanction or the prayer they are doing. The suras, they are following the sastras, and according to sastra, they are engaging their activities and try to enjoy. Asuras, they don't follow the sastra, go against the sastra, whimsically they do. Prabhupada tells in the Bhagavad Gita, whimsically they do. That's what called pravrittimsa, nivrittimsa. They don't know. What to do, what to know. Okay, you want to enjoy, there are ways. Karmakanda portion of all Vedas are for that. Every small petty thing to big thing you can enjoy with the sastra. There is no nothing left in the things. Even Bhagavad Gita it tells. You want to enjoy family life, dharma avirata bodhesa kama ushmi bardasava. Even the family life you want to enjoy, doesn't matter. Go according to sastra, dharma avirata, don't go against the sastra. Asuras go against the sastra and they enjoy, suras they try to enjoy according to sastra. What is the difference? What is the advantage of one enjoying without sastra and one enjoying with sastra? If somebody tries to enjoy without sastra, he gets lost to fall down to animal life. In the chapter, Krishna is telling in Bhagavad Gita, at the end, I am repeatedly putting down in the hell, repeatedly, so never he can come up. Because he is degrading his life. When he goes against the sastra, he is degrading life to the lowest animal life. But what is the advantage of enjoying according to sastra? Because sadhureva mandavya, he is sadhu, he is following because of his past vasanas, he has to go through all these steps. Therefore, slowly he will come down, come up. Both are enjoying, one is according to sastra enjoying, one is without against the sastra enjoying. Without whimsical, not against also. It doesn't know what to do, what not to do. Prabhupada used the word whimsical. Such a person, he fall down, degraded to very lower species of animals. Whereas, the devotee is also enjoying. You take family life or eating or sleeping or anything. But he does according to sastra and as a devotee, even sometimes he may not follow perfect sastra. But as a devotee, continues sadhana. And continue with that he is doing. Slowly he will be able to come out. Like a child trying to walk. Many times it fall down. But finally, if it doesn't give the effort, it is able to walk. Similarly, a person who is in sura, but he wants enjoying propensity, what else? Everybody has enjoying propensity in this material world. That's why we have come here. But do according to sastra, that is sura. Who is not doing against sastra, who is without badrishana sastra, asastra vidhi utsurja. So you throw away all the sastra things and try to enjoy, you are falling down. That's why the whole process is only sastra vidhi. That is material nature goes according to the karmakanda portion. Another is devotional platform. This is better platform. The devotees automatically become sura. The Lord insects him and bring him to the back to the position of sastra vidhi following, and also he may not be able to deviate, he is sadhureva mandi, he will come back one day. This is the main difference between sura and asura. And asuras, It's a very easy. Pitiable that things they cannot come up. I'll repeatedly put them down. Krishna is still such a the Unnata Sloka in Bhagavad Gita, it's very shocking. This is the Unnata Sloka. He tells it they can come or never come up. I'll put them again and again down. Why? Because it doesn't follow. He doesn't take the right path. He doesn't become the devotee. He doesn't become Sastra. Even Sastravadi who is following Karmakanda person, they may not be devotee. But in the process, they will become devotee. This is steps before becoming devotee. Ego wants to enjoy. Let's say you see, you know, that Bhagavatam is talking about the Pranchana story, Prajana Parhishit. He wants to enjoy, but he was doing full Karmakanda. Therefore, the Karmakanda activity is preliminary to the devotion. Somebody who wants to enjoy. It's better than the asuric nature. This is Sura nature. Okay, you follow Sastra. That's why Devas, they're following. But if they are little devotees, not perfect devotees, pure devotees. They have lot of taste, material, sense gratification mixed. But still they are in the process of devotion like us. And in the process, we may be able to elevate ourselves to the better position. One is very preliminary step is Karmakanda portion. Very lowest is Asura. They are repeatedly pushed down to the lowest species of life, as Krishna tells in the Bhagavad Gita. The next level is Karmakandis. They go by Sastra, Vedas, a lot of karmas, yajna, this, and so many things. They worship, demigod worship, everything under Karmakanda. You want immediate benefit. That's why so many things are Karmakanda portion of Vedas are telling. They are the next level. They are using that and try to enjoy their material propensity. They are using. Next level is the devotees. With mixed devotion, karma mix, all this, taste mix, everything, somewhat coming. And these finally they ended up as a devotees, pure devotees. These devotees, even though they have this propensity, since they are in the right direction, they will come up. They will get out faster. That's why the whole process is, we need to encourage them, get them right direction, even with the gratification they come, make them to feel comfortable with the right direction, right way, that way they will be able to come up. And one who is advanced, they have to guide. Who is getting advanced, they have to take the guidance. This is a very simple process. This is what that Sura Asura matters and how that evolving, that how one should evolve to the condition of devotees from the asuric nature. But asuric nature is, Krishna is telling very horribly that you cannot come up, I'll repeatedly push them down. Then what is the, supposed to be, Krishna is supposed to be equal to everybody. Then why Krishna is using such a word? Prabhupada is explaining the purport in the Bhagavad Gita. But the only way is, by becoming asura, Krishna is so merciful, he is equal to everybody, therefore, he takes avatara to kill them and to make them liberate. For asuras, by blessing is liberating. For asuras, by killing is liberating. Both are equal. Like all Ravana, Kamsa, Hiranyakashipu, everybody was killed and was liberated. But asuras are different way. That asura nature is so horrible. One of the things is krodha. We know that the 7 told bhavas, you can remember Krishna. Among the 5 are positive, 7 are negative. 5 positive we know, this is Sura nature. Sanda Bhava, Vatsalya Bhava, Dasya Bhava, Sagya Bhava, Madhurya Bhava. These 5 are positive side. You can remember Lord through positive way. That is 7 are negative way, asuric way. They are also remembering. Like Kamsa, Sisubala, everybody there, I don't remember the quotes. One is jealous, one is hatred, one is fear, one is angry. All these are asuric hatred. You can remember Krishna also. Even this path of asuras also, they are remembering Krishna. But negative way, 7 way. But some or other way, Krishna is taking that also positive and try to liberate them. They are becoming too much asuric, they are killed. And you know Sisubala, he was born that time with a 3rd eye in his things, and his aunt, his auntie, his mother, Subala's mother, to Krishna. And Krishna was taking the child in his thing, that mother is worrying, what is that and all. Then he hears a voice that the time of birth of the Sisubala, when the eyes fall down, over lap, when the child is kept, when eyes fall down, that guy will kill the Sisubala. Then when Krishna goes there and he kept on that, Sisubala's things fall down. Then his mother begs, my child, don't kill him and all those. He's asurik, fully asurik, but Krishna promises, okay, I'll tolerate him up to 100 offenses. Once he crosses 100, I'll kill him. Then really, in the yagya, Rajasu yagya, Sisubala is so much criticizing, he's counting 100 crosses, he cut him. Even that is benefit. That's an asuric nature. They are also benefited. Prabhupada tells, only by killing Krishna is benefiting. But Prabhupada is so merciful. The Vaishnavas was also so merciful than the Lord. Prabhupada tells many places than the Lord. They bring even asuric nature people also to the devotion. Prabhupada is the best example. When Prabhupada brought all the people who doesn't know what to do, what not to do, and very heavy in their nature, and no Shastravidhi following, all anger, kobo, everything tense, everything, all asuric nature filled up, hatred, everything, Prabhupada by mercy brought. Prabhupada often tells, in other yugas, Lord killed the asuras, but in this Kali Yuga, kill asuric nature. We don't kill asuras, we kill the asuric nature. Prabhupada taught us how to kill the asuric nature. We are all asuras. Why we are asuras? We want to enjoy everything against Shastra. We don't want to follow any rules and regulations. We are like Prabhupada used to tell, we conditioned souls are marginally independent. But our tendency is to be fully independent. We don't want to depend on anybody, depends on what to talk about. We don't want to depend on Lord also, we don't depend on. But still all these conditioned souls who are asuric, Prabhupada is so merciful, he taught us how to kill the asuric nature. In the Kali Yuga, you cannot kill asuras by body. Because even somebody was killed, that asuric nature is not killed, again he is born as asura. Because the Sukshma Sarira is going with mind intelligence, ego goes with him. There is no escape. Again, he is born with the same nature, asura nature. Unless you kill the asuric nature in this birth, the asuric nature will continue next birth also. Therefore, this is a better process than killing the body of the asura. This asuric nature should be killed. Prabhupada, how wonderfully he has taught us to kill this asuric nature. Little follow, he has given everything. He has given everything. And he has made simplified. He gives a very, very simple way. Like a very simple way he has given. Hold my dhoti, I will take you. That's a Prabhupada word. Simply follow the instruction, we can get it, everything out of it. We don't need to break our head with all these shastras, everything. It comes because we can, how Prabhupada is mercifully, even Krishna told, I put down these asuric people, but Prabhupada is brought all this asuric nature, killed the asuric nature, and eternally is giving us benefit, right direction. That's why we go to crores and times, we go to be janme Prabhu Sai. He saved us. Otherwise we are a very worst people. Outside very decent people, inside we are very asuric. Everybody has the tendency for all the enjoyment. But he taught us how to get out. He brought in the proper direction. He taught us the mantra, he taught us the prasadam. Every simple things he gave it, not without burden. Like a very caring a child, he is carrying us and he is killing all the, protecting us like a bird is protecting its small one with its fans and other things. Similarly, Prabhupada is protecting us. He has given every small thing. This is what, when I was reading this, I got wonder, this asuric nature, how we have the tendency for asuric nature, because enjoyment, going against Shastra, Everything is with us. We don't know what to do, what not to do. Certainly, before coming to ISKCON, who knows what to do, what not to do? Nobody knows about regulative principles. Now the common culture is violating regulative principle is the fashion. In the name of fashion, all violation is there. If you don't follow the violation, you are very orthodox and very old. You are very outcast in the society. We are all outcast. If you follow properly, you are outcast. If you are adjust with the people, that's why some devotees also sometimes bewildered. And outside world is violating all these things. Oh, is it the fashion? I also should do. They get lost. Prabhupada now very clearly told what should be done, what not to be done. He has given clearly, we should not give even leniency of other directions. Even little leniency in the mind will bring down to the all level, down. Let us be careful. Why? What not the Prabhupada is going? Everything Prabhupada gives, what to be done, what not. I was surprised, we were one of the meeting, Prabhupada, one of the senior Swami, Sannyasi was telling, Prabhupada told a simple formula for all accounts maintaining and all those things. Imagine. Put every single paisa in the bank, take and spend, then bank will tally all your account. This is a proper formula. Means how to bring everything into account. This is one simple formula, follow, everything will be followed. Such that he has given, what not he has given. We don't want to go for all shastra searching for all instructions. Prabhupada has given. Even as his life you go through, we see, under this, how is it possible for us with such a asuric nature? Asuric nature means pravrittims and nivrittims. We don't know what to do, what not to do. We have a lot of krodha, hatred, this all seven characters which these people were, seven bhavas, Krishna, same seven bhavas. We have with human beings, with animals, with everything, eating everything, killing everything, hatred, bitter feeling, anger, fear. Everything is this asuric nature. With all those things, how is we are coming out? I start smiling after chanting Krishna consciousness and coming to ISKCON. I don't smile also, I don't write letter also. I was like, mostly the world is like a psycho. Unless you come to devotion, your mind is so horrible. So many fears. What is the life? What is the thing? Oh, how hatred starts, how these things, gratification one side pulling us, hatred inside developing in us, and we are anger, we are these things, and we don't know what to do, what is correct, what is not, what is life. So many questions comes, when fear comes, death comes, we fear, disease comes, we fear. All these things are making our life hell. With all those things, great solution Prabhupada gave. These are all asuric nature. We brought this out of us. Still is bringing us out of us. And still is helping us. This is a very easy method he gave. Even though that's a slogan, asuras will be never promoted to higher seat, but to Prabhupada promoted by devotee's mercy. This is a very common thing. And a very easy thing he told. Another is, sometimes the asura guna is confused with the rajoguna. Rajoguna is different. Rajoguna, they go according to Shastra. They are very passionate, but still they follow Shastra. Asuric, they don't follow Shastra. Rajo, they know what to do, what not to do. But they are passionate, very heavily active. Because in the Rajoguna, somebody pass away, they are coming born among the karma sangisu. The karma who are very active people, they are born among them. But asuric things, he goes to the animal life. They are not in this life. Prabhupada tells repeatedly they will be put down in the Bhava. Krishna also tells. Therefore, there is a plenty of difference between asura guna and asuric nature and rajoguna. We should not confuse. First thing is, one is according to Shastra, rajoguna. Asura gunas are not according to Shastra. Rajoguna, they know what to do, what not to do. Asura guna, they don't know what to do, what not to do. And these all vary under rajoguna. They can be elevated to Sattvaguna easily. From Sattvaguna they can go to Sutta Sattva. But Rajoguna, the asuric nature, they will be continuously degraded. Because they don't follow the Shastra, they don't know what to do, what not to do. Unless Krishna born as avatar and kill them, or some Vaishnavas, some devotees show mercy and bring them up. This is the difference between asuric nature and this nature, rajaguna thing. And sometimes rajaguna nature, one can be easily elevated. Simply they can brought down to the sattvaguna, because when somebody is heavily acting in rajaguna, and naturally comes to sattvaguna, the mind works. What for I am working? What for these things? It comes. But tamaguna is very dangerous. From tamaguna, getting elevated is tough. It pulls down. Asuriguna is still higher than the tamaguna. It pulls you down. Therefore, a separate chapter Krishna tell three things, and one is Daivasura. This different chapter, that difference is little very fine, and things we can sense it. And unless we understand, we sometimes that confusion comes. What is asuric nature and rajaguna nature, and this tamaguna sometimes mix, and it is not sura nature is not fully the sattvaguna, but devotee nature is sutta sattva. Sura is in sattvaguna, but so. Devotees are supposed to be Sutta Sattva. And sometimes the devotees, Sutta Sattva means, it looks like they may work like in a different mood. They so anger, they so do. But the purpose is, they are acting in Sutta Sattva means, this is different. Externally, there may be confusion how, when devotees are acting in anger or something, or scolding or shouting, but he is doing Sutta Sattva means in devotion, that is higher than the Rajo and Sattvaguna. Sometimes Sutta Sattva will be confused with Rajoguna and other things externally, but internally what purpose, how to find it? The Sutta Sattva somebody is doing, all these, sometimes he has to do that Rajoguna activities. For example, management means Rajoguna. If you don't have Rajoguna, you cannot manage. In Sattvaguna, you cannot manage. You find everybody is equal. How can you manage? How can you instruct? How can you guide? Rajoguna, some rajoguna is needed. Some injected, then only you will be able to manage. Therefore, but as a devotee you do rajoguna, that becomes sutta sattva. As a non-devotee you apply rajoguna, it becomes a material rajoguna. It gives a defect. Therefore, sutta sattva combines all these three gunas with devotion. Sometimes you see you can see rajagunas, tamagunas, some activities devotees may do, but in devotion, maybe advanced devotee, I am not telling neophytes. We cannot imitate. That's a gunas different. Therefore, the asura and the sura, that is a different topic, I don't go detail. And these three gunas, all these things, if we know the difference, that life can be simple and we can move forward. We can move forward. We are not certainly not very advanced. We are in the very lower level. But if we propose on the direction, we can move forward. I am personally realized for 35 years, I am doing 35. Not even single moment I went back in my thought. He is directing. He is showing direction. He is very clearly showing the direction. No Shastra I know. I don't know Krishna. I don't know Bhagavad Gita. I don't know anything, but I know Prabhupada. He has shown everything. Through him I am seeing everything. Maybe I am verifying what Prabhupada is telling is correct in this by reading this. I am unable to see all the things different from what Prabhupada told. He has shown much simpler direction. This I may not understand. His purport, everything explains, his voice explains, his life explains, his how he brought up all the disciples, all these things, how brought up the movement, how such a lower level, he brought everything to higher level, how one is able to withstand. Okay, some may be having some difficulty, but still they are advanced. Nega bikramo na sosti pratyavayana vityade. There is no loss. The day will come, again they will take. So even if we cannot achieve in this life, Sushinam Srimadangaya Yoga Prashta Vijayade, the day will come and they will get a good. These are all consoling, convincing, and so that they follow the process. Don't give up this process. Like a child, you fall thousands of times, still don't give it up. Continue. It's a very sober way, very gentle way, very simple way, very compassionate way. The passionate people, they give a compassion way, proper. Therefore, we are fortunate. We got such wonderful things in this society, and we never should lose it. This is my humble request. All the devotees and everybody, not even single bit of thought you should have to take it to Prabhupada's shelter and go ahead, it will be a very nice, my personal experience, I find I don't see anything else. I go through sometimes many difficulties, things are solution. And this simple thing is how Asuri, I was very passionate, I was used to work 18 hours in the full of R&D research and development, I don't have time for anything else. I was such an Asuric nature, I don't know what is that, with the tea, those days, Karmi days, with the tea and the biscuit I work, all the things, not even take food, and such a way I was working. But the day comes, proper mercy, some devotee made me to chant, and this comes, all these things, and from there, some Vaishnava was merciful me, all devotees are merciful, and Prabhupada is merciful, I got this opportunity. I am very grateful to all the Vaishnavas who gave this and Prabhupada, and we should never miss it. Anybody comes, Prabhupada cries, even a single devotee goes out, he cries. Oh, after many, many births, the soul has come to this. How can it go back? That's why we don't miss it. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Any questions? Yes. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. You mentioned that Suras in a day Sudha Sattva, devotees are in Sudha Sattva.
Devotees are Suras.
Suras. Devotees are Suras.
Yes. Suras Devas, actually Suras is, Prabhupada is mentioning devotees, but really Sura mentions the Devas, demigods. Demigods also devotees. But demigods are with the taste for enjoyment, material enjoyment. But they do according to Shastra. Yes, Indra, you see Indra's story, everybody's story, they are all having enjoyment propensity. Yes. They have material enjoyment, but they, with the prayer to Lord, with the surrender to Lord, with according to Shastra, they do, therefore they are Suras. They have material enjoyment.
Is Lord Indra enjoyment?
Devas.
Yes.
Yes. You see the stories, many stories, Indra is violated.
Material
Rama didn't do according that, because according to Shastra, Lord Rama has to, as a Kshatriya king, he has to do Rajasuya and Ashwamedhayaga or something. Even the Yudhishthira king, Yudhishthira did Rajasuya and these things. Because as a Kshatriya king, they are supposed to do. Therefore, as a duty they did as a Kshatriya, but not because of, for sense gratification. And there is a difference between doing for sense gratification and there is a duty, as a duty you do that. That's the 18th chapter of Krishna is telling that it should be done for that purpose without getting attached to the result. Somebody is doing something that is sattva guna. And sutta sattva means the devotion he does. Therefore, Rama is Lord. He did as a Kshatriya king, he came, therefore he has to do as a Kshatriya duty. Even Krishna tells in the Bhagavad Gita, I don't need to do anything, but if I don't do anything, world will follow me. Therefore I am doing. Similarly, Rama also, as a Kshatriya king, he was establishing the tradition. What are the things to be done? Therefore to show the Kshatriya dharma, and as a Kshatriya king he did. Therefore we cannot compare what Rama did. But Indra's position is guarded by any jiva who completes 100 Ashwamedhayaga. Whoever completes, he is qualified to become Indra. That's why when Prithu Maharaja was doing 100th Agnya, Indra was so disturbed. Two times he came and disturbed. Then Brahma came and consulted, why do you want this, your devotee? Why do you combat it with him? Leave it. Then he left 99th. Then the 100th Ashwamedhayaga, he didn't do it. Therefore, the difference between devotee and Suras. Indra got envious about Prithu Maharaj. He is going to become a competitor. But Prithu Maharaj, he as a devotee, he is Sakti Avashavadar, he didn't complete the 100th Yajna. He stopped it with the 99.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Not necessary.
Huh?
You cannot be pure devotee. I am talking like a
pure devotee.
Who is pure devotee? I quickly brief. Indra is a pure devotee, means why he is doing so many. We can tell, but he has read so many things, he violates.
So that is, I will tell
the. No, because.
Not the right place, okay? Let him finish his class.
No, okay. Okay, now. No, we can discuss later because others may have some questions. Okay. Yes, Prabhu. Harish.
Prabhu, the question is, the Sura and the Asura, they are nothing but actually the mind set. It's like the person who is Sura can also exhibit Asuric activities and vice versa is also possible. So we have Sura, Asura, which is nothing but how we exhibit our behavior. Plus, we have all these three modes, you know, mode of goodness, passion, and ignorance. So all these things are so much complex. You know, sometimes you may see a person unintentionally, he may exhibit a certain quality which he doesn't know that he is doing. But you know, he cannot check himself. Sometimes it so happens. So how does a person correct himself? Or is this the process which finally needs to help him over a period of time? Or is there, you know, how does he get out of it?
The question is, there are asuric and the sura nature, as well as the three guna, sattva, rajo, tama guna. And the people sometimes without out of ignorance, without knowing, they may act in different things. And how we correct or how we come out of the things. Simple thing is devotion. Devotional activities, you continue with your guna, but continue your devotion. In that process, you come to Sutta Sattva. This is above all this guna. Nistra Gunya Bhavarjana. The whole devotional process is beyond the gunas. Therefore, a person really doesn't bother so much about what guna is there and other things. Engage in devotion. You see Prabhupada, how did he engage? He didn't bother about what guna the people came with the background. He engaged everybody according to the nature. Similarly, everyone has to, some nature, it's a born nature, comes in course of birth, and we cannot overnight change it artificially. Paradharma bhayavagat, sodharma nidhanam sreya. Our own character only we have to live with that, but we can tune it in the Krishna service. That is way we come out of this. Three gunas. Otherwise, we will get locked up. We don't think also. We do the devotion service. You remember Prabhupada's time, he write in the Leelamada, somebody, Prabhupada was giving lecture in the beginning days. Somebody comes with inside things, some drunkard, and he kept some toilet paper, go and toilet tissue paper inside the toilet and come back. Prabhupada is telling, see, he has also some serving mood. That's the way Prabhupada saw the things. He didn't criticize him, oh, this crazy guy and all those things. He has some serving mood, he brought it. His mood is like that, he served like that. He cannot do pranam, he cannot do big things, but he does some service. Therefore, the whole process of devotion is, he cannot be restricted by gunas. Just to engage the guna in whatever, but in the over the, it doesn't mean you have to be in that same guna, you will be evolving. Somebody till the end, it will be like, George Harrison, he cannot fully perfect, follow all the things, but he is one of the way he engages, Prabhupada engaged him in his service. It's all very, that's why Rajavitya, Rajakukhya. It's a very secret, subtle. It's a very tough to understand devotional aspect of everything. So it comes out of guna. Nistre gunya. Come out of the guna. We cannot really think. You see that all was, you know, I used to quote the Srirangam temple, the way he built, you know, no? All kept 200 thieves and all sitting, all these things. He built the temple. How can you accept him? We are accepting as Alvar. Therefore, the gunas doesn't play in the different role in devotion. Externally, it looks like, oh, this is wrong, 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 and other. I remember when Bengaluru temple was construction, the time I was there, and the devotees used to go to everywhere and collect. Once I was working, the time I was working, they called me suddenly on the brahmachari. Come on, we have to go to a place. I went. It is a garak shop. I cannot go inside with saffron. You please go and collect the money and come back. And I got to go inside the Araksha in my lifetime and collected some life donation and brought. See, everything is possible in those. What you are doing, what for you are doing. That is the important thing. You are doing for Krishna. The thing is, by engaging, you are engaging him and all these things. This really is a big topic, how the gunas can be applied in devotion. When you are applying all your gunas in devotion, it becomes Sutta Sattva. How to engage without any bit also, you should be able to take the credit or take the benefit of your activities by your guna and surrender fully in the mode of Krishna. Do your sattva, rajo, tamo, still it works out, devotion. You don't need to change the guna, but you can commit. It doesn't mean you'll continue the guna, you'll evolve from the guna one day. Thank you. Yes, Prabhu.
To continue the same question.
Yes.
So, he is not doing it intentionally, but it happens. So, when he is on the devotional path, so will that give him a reaction? That's what my question is.
Actually, the reaction will be less, but you should continue the devotion. You should not give up. When he continues, the things will automatically get out under the guidance, not on his own. And Prabhupada tells many times, okay, you become devotee. Before becoming devotee, you did so many things, but don't continue it. Maybe one or two times you slip down out of your past things, experience or vasanas, but don't do intentionally. Continue the things. Don't with the systematic planning, don't do it. Don't do whimsically. Everybody has some tendency to fall down. Krishna forgives. Devotees forgives and helps. But you do intentionally, with whimsically, without bothering anything, continue, then it's dangerous. Therefore, everybody has the chance to sleep, but doesn't mean he is out of devotion. He has to continue the path more strictly, more tightly, more vairagya, apyasena vairagyena. Still strong practice, strong vairagya, with that you can come out. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Any other question? Thank you very much. श्रीमद् भागवतम की जय श्री प्रभुपाद की जय